kissing you that August night I knew was my last first kiss. So yesterday, my wife and I were on the bed, and she's all snuggled up like a little Eskimo, and we're looking at our proposal video, and I realized that in the proposal video, my mind went completely blank, and I, when I did the first video, even when I actually proposed to her, my mind went blank both times. I don't know if I was just overwhelmed by the moment or what, but.
I'm down at my house because of you, but it doesn't feel like a home without you down there. Whenever you and Beans are at the house with me, that's when I'm at my happiest. And I just want to feel that feeling forever. I don't even know if you would be my wife.
I wish I could have had a redo at proposing. Maybe I'll set up a better video than this. This is just me spitballing now. But I figure I record this because my wife really, as long as I'm speaking honestly, she's good with it. If I could redo our proposal video, what I would say was, Kristen, the night of the Redskins' third preseason game, when we were at the Stadium Armory Metro Station, waiting for the Orange Line to take us back to New Carrollton, you and I had been basically, we came there as friends, but we pretty much flirted the whole night once I got over us not being able to get into the game initially. And even when we got to the game, I really didn't pay that much attention. I really paid more attention to you and taking selfies with you up in the stands. And you wearing my hat or my visor, that was pretty cool. You know, you wearing my hat and all that. But honestly, at the Metro station, I don't know if we had just started holding hands or whatever, but I feel like our proximity had gotten closer, and like I could kiss you right now. And then we did. It was mutual for all you folks. No, I did not force my way. It was mutual, but with the kiss, it was like you kissed, and then in that moment, it's like God removed the veil from your eyes. It's like God removed the fog from your head, and you could see everything clearly. And in that moment, I'm like, I might have just kissed my wife. And then, yeah, it was kind of a surreal moment. And then we get to the car, of course. And I'm getting pulled off, and you stopped me, and you said, kiss me again. And then it's like, you had another opening. Like, dog, I think this was my last first kiss. And of course, you know, me being cautious Ricky, I'm going to try to take forever to find out if this is it. I'm going to try to research everything. I mean, heck, it took me a whole year to decide on a cell phone one time. But it's like, I know what I'm feeling, I know what I think, but this is a huge decision, man. This is like the rest of my life. This is the rest of her life, and she says yes. But it's like in that moment, I was like, I just kind of knew that was my wife. In that moment, it was all laid bare. Kissing you opened me to seeing you as you were created to be in God's image. And I don't know about you, I hope, but for me, that magic I feel is still there every time. I still have those feelings like, yeah, she's the one. You know, yes. So for my hopefully upcoming daughter, this is the only female I need to kiss, only female I'm going to kiss. But, well, I would have said that. I would have said, kissing you that August night, I knew was my last first kiss. I hoped it, but deep down I kind of like knew it. This is it. Now, even becoming a boyfriend and girlfriend, it's like I never really just thought about that. Okay, we're just going to be boyfriend and girlfriend and see where it goes. Like, no, I'm going to be her boyfriend and I want to be her husband. I just always said in my head, I never just had to ask, let's see what happens. I do want my destination, what I wanted my destination to be. And that was hitched to you. And I'm grateful. I'm glad you said yes.
Blushing.
You're blushing? Getting close. Well, I see them red cheeks. She's hiding. I don't regret one thing. Thank God for everything. And I saw this one Instagram post yesterday and it was perfect. It's like, I might not have been your first kiss. I might not have been your first love. I might not have been your first date. Heck, I'm not even your first baby daddy. But I'm going to be your last everything. Your last kiss, your last first date. The last baby daddy. But just being the last of everything, that means God has put it together and has locked it up. I'm happy.
Does that mean I'm coming?
Going in for it.
Huh?
So I'm going in for attempt number 3, blood test number 3. All right. Give him some good blood.
Did our third blood test for an IUI that we had 2 weeks ago. We did the third blood test this past Monday and it was unsuccessful. So still no baby Johnson. We are planning a getaway for our 2-year anniversary. Looking forward to that. God knows I'm looking forward to that, and I know Kris is too. We can't wait to get away. But with getting away, just being able to reset, she would have been starting again with the clinic next week if we had stayed in town. But we decided we're going to take a break. Medicine, doctors, yes, they can all be God appointed, but they've not improved our chances or decreased our chances. They've not, I mean, I know it probably sounds negative, but I mean, you know, nothing has changed since we started. Our whole summer has basically been fertility clinic. Working with Shady Grove pretty much the whole summer. Since May, so spring until summer. And nothing's changed. So, honestly, I think this month, maybe even next month, I don't know. We're just gonna throw it in God's hands. He's the ultimate doctor. He's the ultimate technician. He's the ultimate nurse. So we just put it in God's hands so God can do whatever God's going to do in this season. Still trust, still leaning. It's hard, but it's necessary. We still have some disappointments, but I don't have any regrets. So we're going to do what we're going to do. We're just going to enjoy our time away and, like I said, put it in God's hands and let it be as He lets it be. Another thing I guess I'll conclude with that I have to remember is that God did answer my prayer. I did pray to God for a child, and you might have heard some thumping and bumping upstairs, and that's Tristan. I mean, so, no, I did not birth him, but he's mine. He's upstairs wearing a Metallica t-shirt right now.
I wonder who you got that from. So, God didn't answer a prayer. I'm glad I'm able to be a part of his life. And I'm treating him just like his last name was Johnson. And even if God does bless us with our own child, I'm still going to continue to treat him like a Johnson. So anyway, pray for us. Still in a season of waiting. But the heaviness of the weight is coming off because my trust and my dependence has to increase. Because of the pandemic, we had an option of keeping Tristan home at the beginning of the school year so he can learn virtually. So with that said, we wanted to set up at least an area where it could feel like a classroom for him. So Auntie E, PK, and Kris, they all set up part of the dining room to feel like his own little personal classroom.
I'm the worst at dancing.
It's okay, you get it on.
Alright, everybody. I am the worst at dancing. So if anybody's watching this, somebody please teach me the karate move and the dance move.
Why don't you go with PK? She's trying to help you. So once we got Tris squared away, it was finally our time. So we decided to go down to Loudoun County, Virginia, and we're just gonna enjoy our anniversary together and enjoy a couple days for just us. So we went to a nice restaurant for dinner, and Kris, she likes to dress up. So she was dressed to the nines, and of course she's gonna take her pictures. And after that, we went to Bro Winery. And there we had our personal wine tasting. And we rather enjoyed ourselves. My wife, she's the wine drinker, but I had fun with her. Let us drink wine together on our knees, on our knees. Let us drink wine together on our knees, on our knees. When I fall on my knees, with my face to the rising sun, oh Lord, have mercy on me.
What?
A big hindrance to the whole childbirth process is just feeling stressed out all the time. When your body is stressed, your mind is stressed. And, you know, even though we are appreciative for working with Shady Grove and, you know, the potential that it could have, it gets stressful. Always trying to make doctor's visits, going in for blood tests, waiting for results. So just taking a break, I think, you know, was good for us mentally and just gave us time to just reconnect without having that hanging over top of us. So who knows, maybe in this time of just us being together and not worrying about the doctors, who knows, we might get blessed. We might have a little baby Johnson that, you know, gets conceived in this time. But we'll find out.